Rice production has shot up in the northern region, upper east and upper west, and in the western regions. But according to the farmers, tons of staple food is going bad due to the lack of storage facilities and a ready market for the produce. While the increase in production should be welcome news for a country that is seeking to be self-sufficient in food production, the rice farmers are rather going through hard times. In some farms, the matured rice remain on the fields because of what has been harvested, and what is left there is clearly not getting a market, so it's not sold. Tons of bags of rice have been packed in farms and along the shoulders of major highways with no buyers inside. Some of the farmers argue that the country's high rice imports is the reason for the glut and want government to intervene. It's pretty unfortunate. Some of the news we are hearing is that it has had to take the farmers quite some kind of extra investment, where they tell them to buy two bags of rice and then they get a third one for free. Let's go to the phone lines now and speak to the chief executive officer of the National Buffer Stock Company. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for your time.
Good afternoon.
Clearly, there seem to be some concern regarding how we are able to serve the farmers, and after years or months of hard work, when they harvest, there is no ready market. That is why the National Buffer Stock Company Limited was set up. Would you agree that you are failing the farmers looking at the excess food that is going waste?
Okay, thank you very much. We are not failing the farmers. Our outfit is a listening outfit, which is responsible for food security. We got wind of this information 3 days ago. So quickly, we went to the fort where the story was captured. And the situation seems different from what was reported earlier. We were there with your reporter, and he is currently in the Upper East region. I came back this morning to attend to a technical committee on rice marketing.
Right.
So, yes, Buffer Stock Company is established to provide a market for farmers.
Mm.
We only come in when farmers are having difficulties in selling their produce, because we are not in competition with any buyer. We are only there as government to come to the aid of farmers when we think they have no other market. So
yeah.
Before we come in,
mm-hmm.
we do what we call crop budget analysis. This crop budget analysis is to ascertain how much a bag of maize or rice should be bought, or a farmer should sell to a licensed buying company registered under Buffer Stock. We have the farmer representation on the committee. We have the licensed buying company representation on the committee. So when we got to the fort to ascertain the story,
mm-hmm.
to our surprise, there was this issue of farmers are selling 3 bags for 2 bags, which is not true.
Really?
It is not. Yes, it is completely not true, because it has to do with the packaging material, the size of the sack. They have this long sack,
yes.
which they fill after harvest. So when the buyers come, they come with a medium one. So three of their medium, two of the long ones from the farmers will fill the three of
small
the medium ones from the buyers.
Okay. But you are saying that what was reported in the media as against what you saw is not true. It is not just TV3.
I was personally there at Fundisi yesterday.
Right. So it's not just TV3 that is reporting this. We've seen other media houses carry a similar campaign where they've also gone there to see huge acres of rice farms, and the farmers have been complaining since that they do not have
the ready market.
Over the years
in the north, when you go, that is how we harvest our produce. Yes, you see stalks of paddy being dry. Some of them are put in the sacks. But yesterday, within first 1 hour of our visit, three articulated trucks came to load. You can find out that from the media houses that we took, including TV3.
Okay.
They came to load. So what we are doing is that, look, we have farmers at heart, because we brought in planting for food and just, and for that matter, we must find them market.
Yes.
So immediately we said, look, we have lenses buying, because their challenge also was that they were relying over on one off-taker over the years.
Okay.
He has failed them, because last year there was no incident of farmers in Fumbisi complaining of no market.
We know also that you promised in June this year that you are going to get an extra 50,000 ton storage capacity. What's the latest on that, and how would that fit in the scheme of things?
Yes, currently within that particular area, we have two new warehouses that are almost 100% complete, which it will be completed by the end of the year. Apart from that, we have extra 15 new warehouses that we are constructing in the region, Upper East region. And nationwide, out of the 80 warehouses that we have awarded contract, 50 from Ministry of Special Development Initiative and 30 from Ministry of Food and Agriculture, 40 would be completed by the end of this year.
Mm.
So we have also identified storage. When we came to power, we realized that, look, you cannot have an effective food security management without the appropriate storage
facilities. And talking about storage, do we have enough rice to feed the nation as we speak?
Currently, as we speak, my outfit is responsible. The National Food Water Company is responsible for the supply of the feeding component of the Free Senior High School program. And we are supplying them local rice nationwide.
Okay.
I've been around visiting the schools, campaigning on the need to eat the local rice. You know, my brother, taste and preference takes time.
Yes, sure.
Some of our wards have never tasted local rice in their lives. So we need to educate them the importance, the nutritional value or importance of taking local rice. The acceptability is very great.
Mm. Right. My final question to you would have to do with the fact that previous government and your current government have tried to help farmers by giving them subsidized fertilizer, implement farming tools, etc. In the anticipation of bumper harvest, did we not anticipate the current bumper harvest so we have enough storage for the bumper harvest when it does happen?
We have anticipated that from day one, that we put the planting of food and crops roadmap on the table.
Mm.
It is on the back of that we are constructing this 80 number warehouses. Once we are done with that, the other districts that have no storage facility will also benefit from it, because it is one district, it is a promise, one district, one warehouse.
That is a long-term plan.
And then also, what has also contributed to the bumper harvest too is that the type of seed, the improved seeds that the Ministry of Food and Agriculture or the planting for food and just have given to farming.
Okay.
It's what has accounted to the increase in yields, because it is an improved seed, which is different from what the traditional seed farmers were using over the years.
Okay.
So our government, we are very committed. We are very committed in supporting farmers, because we are spending so much in planting for food and jobs, and for that matter, we will not close our eyes
to
see farmers struggle to market their produce. We are committed in doing that.
All right.
Apart from the Ministry of Education, where we have the Free Senior High School program, we are also bringing other government institutions.
Okay.
Ghana Prison Service, Ghana Police Service, the military, government hospitals, and what of you. We are bringing everybody on board to sign an MOU with them so that we supply these state institutions with made-in-Ghana produce from our farmers.
Grand. Thank you for at least visiting the place and joining us to tell us what you observed. Alhaji Hanan Abdul Wahab is the Chief Executive Officer of the National Buffer Stock Company Limited. Our reporter Peter Adato actually broke that story over the weekend, where he went to Fumbisi and adjoining communities, spoke to some of the farmers, and they were lamenting the fact that they harvest, the rice is left, it was growing moldy, they were not getting people to come and purchase, and for which reason the National Buffer Stock saw that story and followed up to go and ascertain for themselves the veracity of the story. He's giving a counter opinion. Now, we'll talk to Peter Adato shortly, because he was there with the chief executive of the Buffer Stock Company to find out why there seemed to be a different story from him as against what we had seen, and what kind of promise has he given the people. So when Peter joins us on the line, we'll put some of those questions to him. But clearly there is the concern about how farmers are crying countrywide that they produce, but then there isn't the ready market for their produce that they harvest from the markets. Why are we reporting this in 2019 when we can have proper storage facilities to at least help, especially the perishable goods, and the fruits, etc., that do not have a long shelf life? When we do get Peter, I would ask him what the farmers have been telling him.